Okay, so I'm gonna give you a quick how to catch snakehead. Now, I know you can catch snakehead in rivers and ponds around the world. I know they're an international fish. Sometimes, I think in America, they're a nuisance. And a lot of places, they require you to kill a fish before you throw it back in or keep the fish and eat it. So this is just for South Korea, Camp Humphreys, fishing snakehead in really thick weeded ponds, okay? So what are you gonna need? Rod and reel, braided line, steel leader if you're not a cheap ass like me, and hollow body topwater frog with a couple of double hooks that will get revealed to set the hook. Need some grips to hold the mouth open while you have a buddy or somebody use some pliers to get the hook out. It's a lot easier if you have a friend with you, but if you don't, just like you saw, it's possible, but it's a kind of a pain in the ass because of the teeth. The reason you need braided line is because once you snag that fish, you're gonna have to pull them through a lot of weeds and they're gonna give up a good fight, and they have really sharp teeth. So if you don't have that braided line, they're gonna cut through the other stuff pretty quickly. Topwater frog's got a soft, hollow body so that when the fish bites down, it reveals the hooks, and when you pull on it, it sets the hooks into their mouth, their jaw, whatever. All right, recommended that you use a steel leader. I don't have a steel leader today, I'm being chintzy. Recommended when you get your frog, cut off the legs about halfway. That way, instead of the snake head biting at the legs, they'll bite toward the body, okay? How to set the hook. That's the biggest deal. They'll go after it, they'll bite after it. You'll see them bite it because you're using top water, so you'll see your frog get jumped on, and then you'll see your frog disappear into the weeds. Now, the first thing you gotta do is, one, make sure that you can't still see the frog. I know there's a lot of weeds, so it might be hard to tell, well, did they get it, did they miss it? Because they'll miss a lot. They'll go up to grab it, the weeds will get in the way, and they'll just wind up hitting the frog out of the way. So one, make sure they actually have it. You can do this by feeling them tug on the line, and that's good. You're gonna have to fight your initial reaction. Once they take it, it's exciting and you wanna grab them out right away. Don't, you gotta fight it, and you gotta wait just a couple of seconds. Our theory is that once they grab it, regardless of how they have it, when they go under the water, they take a second chomp at it and reset it, resituate it in their mouth. And that's when you set the hook. So, bounce your frog across the top of the weeds, let it pause every once in a while, move it along some more, let it pause, and usually they'll hit it when it's resting there for a moment. They'll hit it, take it under the water, fight your initial reaction, and wait a couple seconds. One, two, three. Pull the line just a little bit to make sure that you can feel some weight behind it. And then once you do, all your force, try and rip the lips off, all right? They've got really bony, strong jaws. So when you set the hook, if it's on those strong jaws, it's gonna take a little bit to actually get it to sink the hooks in. And then once you're there, once you've got them hooked, you're gonna be fighting through a lot of weeds. Just keep the tension. If he gets stuck, wait. After a while, they'll gain some energy and they'll start shaking around. And once they do, they usually break through the weeds, and then you can pull them up to the top of the water and continue to reel them in. So you need that heavy braided line so that they don't break your line before you get them through the weeds. Let's see, what else? I hope that helps. I'm gonna do a more thorough how-to video with one of my buddies later on, and it'll get a little more detailed as to how to catch these snakehead from this pond, all right? But until then, let's go see if we can catch one. Another one. There you have it. This is my second one for today. this frisky little guy is ready to go back in the water, so I'm gonna throw him back in off the side and we'll continue fishing. There's a good picture of him.